Does your law firm need to track time activities of the associate attorneys that work for you? Well, don't worry. This video is all about time activities for a law firm. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. If you need to track your associate attorney's time for calculating pay or billing the client, you can use the time activities to record and track these work times. A single time activity is an entry that records the time that an associate attorney worked for you for a particular client. A weekly time sheet is simply a set of single time activities grouped by week. These are not transactions. If it is not billable, they will only appear on one report in QuickBooks Online, the report called Time Activities by Employee. Let's add that report to the list of reports that we work with in QuickBooks Online. We click Reports. Now this time we will click Standard because we're pulling out one of the standard reports and putting it in the custom area so we can find it more easily. Scroll all the way down to the bottom of the area of reports until you find the area of employees. And this bottom one here, Time Activities Employee Detail, double click. Now notice, by default, it opens month to date, but in our class, we want to see the results of all transactions regardless of date. So we click the pull down arrow, click all dates, and then click run report. Now we can click save customization, and we can keep the name that they suggest, and click save. Now when we click reports, custom reports, we can see Time Activities by Employee Detail is now added to the custom report list. Associate attorneys are licensed lawyers whom we employ. They could be either employees or independent contractors. That means we would give them a 1099 at the end of the year instead of a W-2. We will show how to record time activities as if they are 1099 workers. That will be the example in these videos. Let's imagine we have Lana the lawyer and Andy the attorney. Now, the way to manage them if they are 1099 workers is to add them to the vendors list because they are simply people whom we pay for a service. If they don't fit under the category of employee. So do you remember how to do that? Go to the left where it says expenses and come across to vendors. Now we can go to the top right and click new vendor and type in the company field Lana the lawyer. Push the tab key and it populates the display name, and later you can come back and add the rest of Lana's information. Click save. And then again click new vendor, click the company field, Andy the attorney, push tab, and again you can come back later to put in the rest of the information, including any notes you might have about Andy the attorney. Click save. The two types of time activities that you can record in QuickBooks Online are single time activities or weekly time sheets. They only keep track of workers' time. You can see what jobs the workers spent time on. Recording them will not affect your financial reports or balances. As soon as you record a time activity, it will show up on the Time Activities by Employee detail. Now, we have already added that report to the set of custom reports. So these examples that we will now record are not billable to the client. And we have to make sure that we check the settings in the account settings window to make sure that when we record time, it does not automatically mark it as billable. We click the cog wheel in the top left and go over to Accountant and Settings. We click the bottom left category of Settings, Advanced, then scroll down to the section of Time Tracking. Now, you may have both of these off, but right now we will not use this feature in this current video. So click the pencil tool to be able to edit the section. Then make sure that we click here and that it is not green and that the little button is to the left. Then we have to save the section. Then we have to go to the bottom right and click Done. Now we're ready to enter our first time activity. We will do the individual time activities first. For example, let's imagine on June 7, Lana, the lawyer, worked 5 hours for client Alan Arby. So how would we record that? Well, we go to the top left and click New. Then we come across to where it says Employees and go down to Single Time Activity. Now, we know the date was June 7th of 2021. And we know that we worked for Alan Arby. The name of the worker is Lana the lawyer. And the job that she worked on was the Alan Arby client. Now, we will not put in the enter the start time and the ending time, so we will remove this check mark. And we will just put in the amount of time, and it says 5 hours. Of course, you can explore and experiment with entering the start time and end time in the break. This is a nice little feature, and it's very easy to use. But we put 5 hours, and then we describe whatever we want to in this field regarding this specific date and these hours worked for this client. This way, we can reopen this activity sheet and find out exactly what Lana did at Allen on June 7th. Now, when we click Save and Close, the only proof will be if we click Reports and we go down to Time Activities by Employee Detail and double click. And of course, it shows not only the worker and the date and the number of hours, but it also shows each client that was worked on as she accumulates time slips. A weekly timesheet is simply a set of single time activities grouped by week. You can enter time in the weekly sheets or individually, and they will be listed the same way in the report. If you reopen the time activity from the report, you will only see the individual time activity one by one. The only way to see the whole weekly timesheet you recorded is to go back to the window that you entered the weekly timesheet and choose the week of the timesheet you entered, and then choose the worker for the timesheet you entered, and then you will find the sheet that you recorded. But there's usually no need for that. Usually, you can reopen it in a single activity window, and that should be enough For our second example, let's imagine for the week of June 13th to June 19th of 2021, Andy the attorney worked the following time and the following jobs. And we can enter them one by one in the same weekly timesheet. The weekly timesheet for this week and this worker. So from the top left, we click New, go over to Employees, and go down to Weekly Timesheet. Notice the columns. We have a columns for the customer and what we did for the customer for each day of the week for this particular timesheet. Now we know in our example it's Andy the attorney, June 13th to June 19th of 2021. Andy the attorney, and we click the pull down arrow. Now this will look different depending on when you are watching this video. But I know I'm doing the example of 2021, so for me right now, this is in the future. And I'm scrolling down to this week, the week of June 13th to June 19th of 2021. So the combination of this worker and this week make exactly this timesheet, and this will be the way to reopen it in the future. Now let's take a look at the weekly time. June 14th, 2 hours for Betty, 3 hours for Alan. Well, that's very simple. June 14th, 2 hours for Betty, and in the same column of Monday, 3 hours for Alan. Now let's take a look at the next day's work. June 16th, 3 hours for Alan, 1 hour for Betty. So, 3 hours, June 16th was 3 hours, so we go to the row of Alan, 3 hours for Alan, and how many was it now? 1 hour for Betty on that very same day. Now, 4 hours for Alan and 4 hours for Betty on June 18th. So we go to the column of June 18th, that's a Friday. In the row of Betty, we put 4 hours. In the row of Alan, we put 4 hours. So the column represents the date, and the row represents which job this worker did. Now all we have to do is click Save and Close, and let's check the results in the report. Click Reports, and scroll down to Time Activities by Employee Detail. You can see everybody's activities listed right here. Here's Lana the lawyer from before with one single time activity, but notice Andy. Each individual time activity that we put in the weekly timesheet is listed here separately as a separate single time activity. In fact, if we double click and open it up, you will go back to the single time activity window and you will not go back to the weekly timesheet. This gives you an easy way of zooming in on the details of that particular time activity on that day for that client. However, if you want to see the timesheet itself, you would have to open the timesheet window and input the same worker and the same week, and then the recorded time will be displayed. So right now on this report, I can only reopen each individual time activity even though it was recorded in the timesheet window. If I want to see the sheet itself, I have to click New, Weekly Timesheet. I have to recall that exact week in time, June 13th to June 19th, and it has to be for that worker, and only then will I see exactly what I put on that whole sheet for that week.